Hare Krishna Prabhu. As you told that the first class method, that to give up all other methods and just follow what is told.
Yeah.
Krishna told in Bhagavad Gita that sarva dharman parityajya, give up all duties and responsibilities, just surrender Krishna. So if a person who want to join and he has his old parents, mothers, this, and another boy is there and he is newly married.
He is doing?
Married, just say he is married. So joining of both of these boys is okay, or that means I want to ask that giving or leaving parents is same as leaving a wife and children? Or why grastha means in varnashrama dharma that it's a grastha life is considered as a ashrama.
Yeah.
So here that leaving family, just like acharya, just like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also left his wife.
Yeah.
Prabhupada also was grastha.
So because you are now talking about varnashrama. So in varnashrama, if somebody accepts grihastha, he cannot leave grihastha life. It is not a, you know, a simple thing. Grihastha life is a very serious responsibility. If somebody accepts a wife, he has to ensure that the wife and the children doesn't come back to this world again. That means first of all he has to ensure that he doesn't come back. Then he has to ensure that other two or three heads, they don't come back again. A very serious responsibility this. Right? So that is, so if somebody accepts that, no problem, but still he can surrender to Krishna, but ensure that he doesn't go by other philosophies in this world. Okay, he has accepted a role of a husband, as a wife or whatever, some role somebody has accepted. Those roles he has to play carefully in Krishna consciousness and ensure that everybody surrenders to Krishna. But as a brahmachari, he has got a different option. According to varnashrama, the parents are supposed to leave the boy at the feet of guru at the age of 5. That's what we are saying. You have delayed giving your boy to the feet of guru by 20 years. Doesn't matter. Now you do it. You hand over now. We are asking that. That's all it is. Otherwise we are strictly according to varnashrama. So brahmachari, he has got that option that either he can remain as a brahmachari or he can get into a grihastha life. He can remain as a brahmachari very easily if he can resist the tricks of mind. What is the trick of the mind? The main trick of the mind is that it always shows the grass on the other side green. That's all. You may be in, you know, you're walking here, it's a green patch, but it will not look so green to you. On the other side, as in the next house, there is some green patches, that looks very nice. Your green patch is not very attractive, that green patch is very attractive. So similarly, for a brahmachari, other side looks very nice. Grihastha ashrama looks very nice. And for a grihastha, this side looks very nice. Or the sannyasa looks very nice. Sannyasi is again looking back and saying, this is nice. This is how it is. This is a trick of the mind. Actually, none of the ashrams are nice. It's all concoction. Why? Dukkhalayam. If you are a brahmachari, grihastha, vanaprastha, sannyasi, you have to live in this world, which is dukkhalayam. Who is saying? The designer of the world is saying, is declared, certified, this is dukkhalayam. After certification has come, if you are imagining some happiness, then that is your problem. Right? There is no happiness, but if somebody is imagining some happiness in any of the ashramas, that is his problem. All said and done, since we are conditioned, we imagine some happiness in this world. That is a fact. We imagine. So, within those imaginations, the better imagination is brahmachari imagination. Remain as a brahmachari. That is good. It's only the tricks of the mind. Prabhupada gives an example of Dilli ka laddu. Dilli ka laddu. Jo bhi khayega, pashtayega. Jo bhi nahi khayega, wo bhi pashtayega. This is Delhi color too. So you resist this tendency of the mind to jump and behave whimsically and think that the other side is good. You have to control this. And how you can control? By the discipline of sadhana. Do your sadhana. You control your mind, engage your mind in the discipline. You have to discipline. If you are in the main temple hall, your mind will say, ashram is nice. Go to the ashram, 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 ashram. There is a pressure like that. If you are sitting and chanting, say, no, walking is nice. Walking, walking, walking. If you are walking, then sitting. Basically, it will not allow you to settle anywhere. Continuously you are jumping from one place to another place. This, that, that. This is the mind's tendency. It will not allow you to settle anywhere. Right? So, you have to resist the tendency of the mind to jump whimsically. And that comes by the discipline. And the discipline is, the training for the discipline is the morning sadhana. Everything has to be attended meticulously by controlling the mind's tendency to pull you out of main temple hall or pull you out of one of the angas. Ah, already too much I have attended. No, let me miss darshanarthi. Let me miss Guru Puja. Let me miss this, that. You know, the mind is continuously trying to pull you out. So this is the tendency. So if you want to resist this, go through this training of disciplining your mind. Then you will remain on the track. No, the training is to remain on the track. They're very important. So then we can come out of this tricks of Maya. On the order of my spiritual master, I have to remain in this track of sadhana. Similarly, tomorrow you can say, on the order of my spiritual master, I have to remain in this track of my ashram. It could be any ashram. Because surrender is not dependent on any ashram. So joining ashram is a very special phase of a devotee's life. It's a very special mercy of the Lord. We have to convince our parents and then join. This is how it happens, and then that is good.